continue to celebrate the Feast of the Epiphany. Please be seated for the song.
A leader and commander for the peoples. See, and nations that do not know you shall run to you, because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their way, and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and succeed in the thing for which I sent it. Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body of sin might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. Here ends the New Testament reading.
Give peace in our time, O Lord. Give unto thy servants that peace and our own Anglican communion. We pray that, like the wise men, we may seek the Christ child in our lives and in our hearts. We pray especially for Christians living in situations of conflict, those who give their lives for their faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our own diocese here in Chichester, its people, clergy and bishops, remembering in particular Martin and Will, our bishops, and Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury. May they seek the light of Christ and his wisdom, and be strengthened in the power of your Spirit. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we remember before you, Lord, those who are sick, those who suffer in mind, body or spirit. We pray especially for those in hospital and those in care, and all who care for them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the souls of the faithful departed, especially those who have died today and in recent days and weeks. We remember those who mourn, and we remember especially any known to us who have died recently, those whose years might occur at this time. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let thy perpetual shine upon them. Generous God, everything we are and have comes from you. In adoration we lay before you the sweet fragrance of our worship. For you alone are worthy of our praise and thanksgiving. In service we lay before you our money, our power, our choices. For in your will we find true freedom and direction. In trust we lay before you also our pain and our longing for healing. For you hold the goal of our life's journey and the hope of salvation. In Jesus Christ, the King of Kings.